Hallelujah. Thank you. The laborer sows the word. The laborer sows the word. He sowed seeds, but some were choked up. Some were choked. Some fell among thorns because of this world. Stuff that we want to choke what you received in the last 6 days. You need to watch out for them. You need to watch out for strife. Avoid it like a plague. You need to watch out for animosity. Unnecessary arguments. All those things are but your provision, which is on its way. Father, we thank you again for an awesome time that we'll have tonight. Lord, we look to you. We thank you, God, because your presence is already here, your manifested presence. We thank you, O Lord, for the help of your Spirit. Holy Spirit, we acknowledge to you tonight, and we submit this meeting into your hands. We acknowledge your leadership, your governance, your management. You speak through my mouth. You think through my mind. I thank you, even though I prepared. I thank you because you will do much more than we can ever ask or think. You begin to work now like never before. Touch every heart. Touch every mind, every person under the sound of my voice tonight. Let them not leave the same way they have come. Let them be turned around. Let them be impacted. Let them live with joy, even in their hearts, with conviction, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you again. So that's the starting point tonight. Watch out for what may want to steal what you've heard in this last few days. Be on guard spiritually. So maybe somebody may call you and want to start another argument. Just thank you. I'm on a journey. I'm about to receive, and I cannot afford strife now. It's too expensive. I can't afford it. Can't afford argument. Can't afford any form of animosity. Make up with anybody that comes. Say you're sorry and move on. And then in the next few days, some of you may feel, oh, it was good while I was on the phone, or it was good while I was on the Zoom call. But now I'm by myself. I feel fear. I feel doubt. I tell you, I want you to shut down your feelings for the next few days. Shut down your feelings and just be consistent in your prayers. Be consistent. This time we've spent tonight, I want you to dedicate it for the next 21 days to God. Say, Lord, from every evening, 7 to 8, I am going to pray. You can use the recordings. I want you to listen to them over and over and over again. When I was believing to be married, I had a jump starter kit. My jump starter kit was some word of faith that I listened to every time I wanted to fizzle, every time, because the enemy may come with doubts, may come with unbelief, may come with stuff that hits your mind, fiery doubt. I want you to make up your mind. No, I'm going to receive. No, God has said it's my time and I have received it. I will not be negotiated out of my provision. I tell you, when I was on this journey, I told some of you that have been to our meetings before and probably heard this. When I was on this journey, I sometimes prayed for 3 days. Sometimes I prayed for 7 days. I prayed and fasted 3 days. I prayed and fasted 7 days. One time I prayed and fasted, 4 brothers showed up, 4 in 1 month, which means I was moving stuff in the spirit. But I didn't marry any of them. They all fizzled out. And some of you have been in relationships like that, cycles. It just happens. As soon as you pray, you get somebody comes in, but quickly it fizzles out. Why? Because you have not pushed to the point of receiving, which is what I want you to do for the next 3 weeks. I want you to keep on it. Put your foot on the gas. Refuse to give up. Refuse to cave in. Refuse to be moved by your feelings, especially for those that live in the UK at this time of lockdown. It's possible for you to be feeling down, feeling depressed. Oh, I'm by yourself. Nobody cares for me. No, 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 no. Jehovah knows your name. He knows where you are at and is set to give you that provision. So this is not the time to let your feelings rule you. When your feelings want to rule you, remember my voice. Go and put the recording on. Put them on. Just play them and listen to them. You will receive. I tell you more than ever before, God is in a hurry to bless his children because the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ is imminent. The coming of the Lord Jesus Christ is imminent. So God is in a hurry to bless his children. He has released your giftings. So now we have to receive it. We have to receive it by putting our foot on the word of God, staking our claim. Don't leave home. Don't wake up a day without spending at least 1 hour in the things of the spirit that relates to this provision, that relates to your believing God. I tell you, when I decided I was tired of being single, and I went on my 21-day prayer journey. I called it a prayer journey, compressed into these 7 days for you. 21 days, every day, not every other day. Every day, I prayed from 7 to 9 o'clock in the spirit. I was speaking in tongues. I was praying. This is how I received my child. This is not, it's the same thing that works over and over again. I was praying in the spirit, dedicating that time to him, because I know he cannot lie. God cannot fail. God, Titus 1:2, God does not have the ability to fail. He cannot fail. He has spoken it. Once the word goes out, the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 4, so shall my words be that go from my mouth. It will not return to me void. It will not come back to me unproductive. That's what the Amplified says. So the word of God is working in your life. Praise God. And I'm that sounding a bit intense, I know. This next 21 days, just stay with it. Stay with it. A lot of us give up too quickly. We go by our feelings. Oh, once the enemy just fires one fury that, oh, I'm feeling so down. Oh, I have so much unbelief. Why? And then keep your mouth. Pastor Agatha was telling us about this. You need to line up your mouth. Don't agree only with God. Don't agree with the word. Don't agree with your age. Don't agree with your, just say, I believe I receive. I believe I receive. Just before I came on now to speak to you, I was reading again the testimonies of people that have received, that has walked through this journey, 60, 50 years old, receiving when they woke up to receive, because God has already given. So your age does not matter. Don't let your age deceive you. I'm 24, I'm 64. Means nothing. Means nothing to God. God has sent forth. He has released your provision, regardless of your age. Hallelujah. So tonight, before we start, and that was my opening line, before we start, I just wanted to say it's time. This is our final day of prayer. Thank you. Big thank you for everybody that has managed to join every day. Now, in this last few minutes, when we talk and pray, we're going to be praying into the relationship. I want you to set your mind completely that this is a done deal. This is a done deal. It is time to marry. Isaiah 62 says, and the Gentiles shall see your righteousness, and all kings thy glory. Thou shalt be called by a new name. Hallelujah. You will not be referred to as a single anymore. It's time to change your status. It's time to change your status. 10 years ago, my pastor preached this message in church. It was relating to something completely different. But that was the Holy Ghost blueprint for me. Thou shalt be called by a new name. It's time to change your name. Hallelujah. You will no longer be termed forsaken. You will not be termed single anymore. You will not be termed desolate. Your new name is Ephesba. Your life, you'll be married. Your land, for the Lord delights in you, you will be married. Isaiah 62:4. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's my starting point tonight. I want that to land. You will be called by a new name. You know, most of us, we grew up with a fantasy about marriage, wearing a white dress, walking down the aisle, flowers, you know, everywhere, the wedding cakes, the wedding rings, the invites, the menu, the photographs, you know, the dancing at the reception, which is just the wedding. That's just one day. That's just one day, which is the wedding. A lot of us tend to focus so much on the wedding, forgetting that marriage is actually a lifetime that people live. You could be in it for 20, 40, 50, 60 years. I know people that have been married for 50 years, 50, and they are still alive, 60 years, you know? So it's not just about the day, about that one day of the wedding, which is what most ladies and think about, you know, just the wedding, just this, the wedding. It's good. But I tell you, the wedding is just a few hours. I think it's about 7 or 8 hours, and you'll be done. So you need to put more energy in preparing for the marriage, which is a lifetime, lifelong journey, rather than the wedding day itself. I tell you, no one sets out to fail in marriage. Nobody started out saying, I'm going to get married to this man and I'm going to fail. Or I'm going to get married to this woman and I'm going to fail. But life happens. Things happen. So it's better to future-proof it. So that to future your marriage, rather than wait until when the marriage is in crisis before you start praying. And that's what we're going to be doing tonight. Praise God. We're going to be future-proofing our marriage, our provision, because it is imminent. It is now. You are now under an open heaven. I was reading a testimony of somebody just before I came just now. She said she had prayed so much and she knew the guy had to arrive. So that day she told her flatmate, I'm going to meet my husband today. She was on her way to work. The flatmate looked at her funny. She said, no, I am going to meet him today. And that day she got into work. Somebody that had known her, met her, and the rest is history. You can pray so much and begin to see, not see somebody in church or and begin to see in the eye of your spirit who your husband should be. As I've said this in our meetings, when before I got married, after I did my 21-day prayer and fasting, I met my husband 5 days after. During my 21-day prayer, prior and during my 21-day prayer and fasting, I began to buy stuff for my husband. I bought him clothes. I bought him suits. I bought him shoes. And they fitted him perfectly. Because I prayed so much, I could see my husband in my eye, with the eye of my spirit. I knew what he had to be this height, because I'm just 5 foot tall, so he can't be 6 foot tall. I knew he had to be this size, because I'm quite small and skinny, so he cannot be a fat guy. I'd seen it with the eye of my spirit. So when I saw him, I knew he was the one. He didn't even need to talk too much. I knew you were, don't worry, I'd seen you. Which can happen tonight as you pray. Pray into your marriage, pray tenaciously into it. It is important that we have the right foundation. Amen. The Bible says in Psalm 11, 3 to 7, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? You know, there's something worse than being single. It is being in a challenging marriage. It's much, you think singleness is tough? In a challenging marriage is tougher. So you need to pray tonight with passion that as I enter, you are entering not to come out, you are entering a peace. It must be a peaceful, a joyful, a blissful. And we are going to be addressing all that in prayer tonight. You know, in Genesis 2:19, we read that whatsoever Abraham called it, it was the name thereof. Anything you call your marriage is what it will be. It will be, it can be hell, it can be heaven. But you are going to call yours tonight what you want it to be. Amen. The Bible says, let the marriage be held in honor, esteemed worthy, precious, of great price, especially be dear in all things. Hebrews chapter 4. Let marriage be held in honor, esteemed worthy, precious, of great price, especially dear in all things. Hebrews 13, one part of it says that. Verse 4. There are lots of challenges going on, but we are exempted. As children of the Most High God, we are excluded from the crisis of a broken marriage, and we can prepare it now. I tell you, after my 21 days of prayer and fasting, that's why I said, because some things may not happen casually. You may have to put a bit of pressure. And I know that's a bit difficult to understand in these days of the microwave. You've been through these 7 days, you have all the resources. I didn't have anything. You have all these resources you are getting today is from those days that I prayed. It's from my journals that I'm sharing with you. This scriptures, the prayer points, everything from the journals. It's time to release them. That's why they're coming out. So we're going to start praying in the next few minutes. I want you to begin to prepare yourself. I want you to begin to thank him. Thank him for giving you the opportunity to be here on Saturday, the conference. On Monday, when we started with the Thanksgiving and preparation. On Tuesday, when we started with the time to remove every limit, begin to thank him. Every limitation, anything that could hinder me from getting married has now been removed. It's completely removed. Begin to thank him. We went into the day of favor. Begin to acknowledge his favor. Thank him for your favor. Thank you for your favor. Thank you for your favor. That is already over my life. I'm already set. I'm prepared. I have it. I receive it. And then we went on to day 4 and day 5 when Pastor Agatha Ademiju was here. It's a time of release. You have been released from everything holding you down. And your husband has been released. Your provision has been released to you. And then yesterday, we went on to pray again. And yesterday was a day of connection. Hallelujah. So you need to go and listen to it over and over. Thank God for the Wi-Fi is nearly. Just get the YouTube on, just save it out and begin to listen to it. In the bathroom, you're listening. Wherever you are, you're listening. Just listen to it for the next 3 weeks. That's what's your assignment. And be praying the prayer. Pray it as if you mean it. Pray it with gusto. Hallelujah. Are we ready to pray? Thank you. Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for the privilege to pray tonight. We thank you because yokes have been permanently removed. Burdens have been destroyed. Burdens have been removed. Thank you, Jesus. I want you to thank him. Release your, wherever you are, thank him. Burdens have been permanently removed. Yokes have been lifted up completely off my life, off my life, off my life. Thank you. I thank you. I thank you. Anything covering me, anything veiling me has been removed. I'm already released. I'm emerging in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray. Rato shtate kradaya giato braka. Zelegredoria katialo de braka yagada. Zilandoria gatialo de broshoto. Zelegedida brozoto toto. Zikaria kashutoria gada. Leshto de broto soto. Rita legridoria kata. Zelegedoria gatolia mashudo. Reto to shoto. Reto shiado breta. I want you to thank him. Thank him intentionally. Thank him. Oh God, I thank you. Thank you, 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 I thank you. You need to praise him. You know, when you praise him, you are lifted. When you praise him, he lifts you. You need to thank him. Raise your hands and bless him. Raise your hands and thank him. Thank him. Thank him. You are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy of the highest praise. And I thank you tonight. I praise you tonight. God who hears. God who answers. Thank you for every day. When I've been on this prayer line, I thank you for all I have received. I thank you for what you have done. I thank you because burdens have been permanently removed. Yokes have been destroyed. Those I know. Those I do not know. Thank you. You have disconnected me from every soul tie, from every disorder in my lineage. You have released me to marry and now receive your provision. Thank him. Speak to him. Speak to him. Speak to him. Unmute yourself and pray. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Register your voice in the spirit. Register it by speaking. Speak that you thank him. Speak that you love him. You are worthy. You are worthy. Thank him. Thank you for making me eligible to marry. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Because yokes have already been removed. Burdens have been restored. Thank you. I thank you. It is my journey of victory. I give you praise. I have victory. 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 I have victory.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now I want you to say this. 1 John 15:16 says that we have been released. I want you to declare that by the blood of Jesus, I am cleansed. I am set aside. I am set aside, chosen to have a joyful, secure, and fruitful relationship with my spouse. Say that. Lord, I declare that by the blood of Jesus, I am cleansed. I've been set aside. I've been released. I've been chosen for a joyful, for a secure, for a blessed relationship with my husband, with my wife. Oh, I want you to say that. I've been chosen. I've been released. I've been set free by the blood of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus. I want you to make much of the blood of the of our land. Make much of the blood. What the blood has achieved. What the blood has secured. I want you to speak it to yourself that by the blood of Jesus, I've been released. I've been set aside. I've been chosen. I've been chosen for a joyful, for a secure, and a blessed, fruitful relationship with my spouse. Pray. Open your mouth and pray. Pray some more. Pray loud. Unmute yourself. Pray. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I've been released. I've been rescued. You have released me from the power of darkness. You have set me aside into the kingdom of your dear son. So I've been released from every burden, from every yoke. I declare by the blood of Jesus, I'm cleansed. I'm set aside. I'm set aside, chosen for a joyful, faithful, blessed relationship with my spouse. In the name of Jesus, Ebrakotoya Kata, Rikosotolo Protoshoto, Orikashoto, Rikasota, Mato,
Mato, Father, I thank you, Lord, because by the blood of Jesus, I declare that I am cleansed for my joyful relationship with my husband in the name of Jesus. I have been chosen, been released for a fruitful relationship with my husband in the name of Jesus.
I declare by the blood, the speaking blood. The word says this blood speaks than the blood of Abel. This blood is speaking over your life, over my life. You need to speak right now. Lord, I thank you. I declare by this blood of Jesus, I've been cleansed, completely cleansed, released, redeemed, and set aside to marry, for have a blessed and a joyful and a secure relationship. Please pray. Ricasto breda kusata. Istali granto shetoria katia ludu. Rete te rito sotoria kashute. Rito roto shoto. Reto shoko. Reto shoto. Ricasate li grando soto. Ah, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for the speaking blood. Thank you for the speaking blood. Thank you for the speaking blood. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We bless you. We bless you. We thank you. Now I want you to pray. If you've been in any of our meetings, you probably had Tina English give her testimony. Her prayers released her husband from every form of bondage he was in. And immediately, you'll be hearing her testimony. I don't want to, you or when we have a meeting on the 19th, you don't want to miss that meeting. You don't want to miss the meeting on the 19th. The dates and the times will come up. But I want you to pray that your spouse, your provision is released from every form of oppression, every form of oppression, every form of financial hardship, anything holding him down, any influence contrary to the Holy Spirit is released from it in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray. Pray with gusto. I pray in the name of Jesus. I release my provision and my provision of a spouse. I want you to pray that you release your spouse from every form of oppression, every form of hardship, every form of shame, every form of influence contrary to the Holy Spirit. Unmute yourself and pray. Thank you. Thank you. I want you to pray again. Pray with gusto. Pray as if you mean it. Say, Lord, I release my spouse from everything that would delay him from seeing me, everything that would delay him from acknowledging me, everything that would prevent him from speaking to me. You know, some men, they just say they are shy. My husband said I was a really shy person. He took all the boldness in the world to come and meet you. I want you to remove all such, anything that will prevent him, anything that will delay him, anything that will hinder him. I want you to break him loose, release him in the name that is superior to every other name. For God has given us a name which is higher than, given him, Jesus, a name that is higher than every other name, that at the name of Jesus, I want you to release him from anything that will hold him, that will delay him, that will hinder him from proposing, from speaking to you, that will distract him, that will divert his attention. Rikasoto riaka. Ikasoto brato rekosto breto ikaria kashato rikasoto reto toto rakusheto rekoshata este bruto shato. I want you to pray. God said in his word, Philippians 2:9, wherefore God also hath highly exalted Jesus and given him a name which is above every other name. Whatever the name of the thing that will prevent, that will delay, that will hinder your spouse from connecting, from speaking, from proposing, atosha. I want you to demand that he be released in the name of Jesus. Be released in the name of Jesus. If you can't pray in tongues, pray in this, pray in English, pray in your language. Just pray. Make sure you're praying. Retosototo, rikashoto, retoshoto, rikasatata, nusoto, riakash. Shiato reto sheto rikasata reto sheto reto to 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 reto to 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 izato riaka nesoto to to reto sheto to rikaka soto reko soto ato shato to soto reto to 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 reto to 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 reto shato. Unmute yourself and pray. Rato shoto reto to 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 shoto. Zoto Kayata, Asateke Dosoto, Asontaria Gasata, Isaiah 34, Rikashuto, seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. No one of these fail, not one, none of you, none shall want her mate. Atta, I know it relates to the word of God adding up together, but those are one of the scriptures I stood on. None of you will want her mate. Wherever your provision is on the face of this planet, I want you to begin to call him out, call him forth from the north, from the south, from the east, from the west, wherever that your provision is, your provision of a husband, your provision of a wife, wherever you are. Zokro soto yega zonikra dosho rika shotoria kaka zutalika zoto reke zoto toto zikalita. I don't care where you are at. You come out now. You come out now. Reko soto zele kridabro zetete. Excellent provision that God has already prearranged for your life before you showed up on this planet. Italikada, he wasn't scrambling. He knew you needed a spouse and he's created one for you already. I want you to speak according to Isaiah 43. I want you to speak. Rekeke. And Isaiah 43:6. I want you to pray. Lashuda Rokoshata. Speak to the north to give up. Speak to the south to give up. Oh, they must not hold back. They must bring your provision. And that the Costa Rica shooter, Brica Solebrato, wherever he is, wherever she is, your path must cross. In these next few days, your path must cross. Ila Croto Shap. Reto toto reto toto to reto shoto rika soto reto toto rika shuto rete brusoto rika shata esototo jita legra doso praka o raposo rupo popo 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 o sataye leshto bragata zede de 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 brusotoria gaziato le bruto shata zetoto soto. Wherever I want you to speak that word again, wherever my provision is, wherever he is, wherever, from the north, from the south, from the east, wherever you are, Atoragata, call the man of God, call the woman of God, wherever they are. Resto Kreshta de Lashto Toto Masotoria Gashado Zetoria Katalabashade Zuto Roposhata Zetoto Rato Shoto Retashata. I want you to pray. Oh God, Lasaka, that the power of the Holy Spirit, you call your faith, your mate unto yourself. I want you to declare every covering or veil over his eyes or her eyes, if you are a man, any covering or veil over the eyes of your spouse. Ah, Tikashata, I want you to pray that those veils will be removed according to the word of God in Isaiah 25, verse 7. He said he would destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over all the people and the veil that is spread over all nations. That veil must be removed. I want you to pray intentionally. Remember that testimony we had on Saturday. That woman was living in the same block of land with her husband. The veil didn't let him see. The veil didn't let her see any veil, any covering over my spouse. Let that veil be removed. Let that veil be removed in the name of Jesus. Let that veil be removed now. Rekoshata. I must be seen. He must see me and I must see him. He must see me and I must see him. Itali kradosho. Every veil has been permanently removed. Roto soto ye de brokoto. Unmute yourself and pray. Recasto brigadosa. Must locate each other clearly. I want you to pray. We must locate each other clearly. No guesswork, no up and down. Is it this one? Is it not this one? Oh, no, no, no. No epileptic relationship, up and down. No, no, no. I want you to pray. Rika Sata, I declare, we locate each other clearly. There is no epileptic relationship. Here today, gone tomorrow. Those days have ended forever. The one that will come now is your provision. He is ready to stay. He wants to marry. I tell you that testimony. I told you that sister called me from America. One of the things we agreed together was an acceleration of the relationship. You don't want a 2 year, 3 year, no engagement. You're already 60. How many more years do you have? No. So I want you to pray. God, we will locate each other clearly. There must be no more delay. There must be no more delay. Unmute yourself and pray. Rikash de debroto yata. Mete de do do do. Reto shoto. Reke soto ria. Reko so. Pray. Rato so. Kaka. Reto prekato. Rika shoto. God hears. Luka do shete. Reto. I want you to thank him. You have made it. You have made it. Thank God. Thank God. I thank you for the manifestation of this marriage by the finished work of the cross, by the intervention of the Holy Spirit. I give you thanks. I praise you. I thank you. By the intervention of Jesus on Calvary, Lord, I thank you. I give you praise. There is no more delay. No more delay. The power behind delay is broken. Oh, Talika Ruka. Lestofrododo rekoshata o rabababa o rabasokoto ateke shoto. Thus says the Lord, I will make this proverb to cease, so that they shall no more use it as a proverb in Israel. Say unto them, the days are at hand. The effect of division is now. Ipakiato neba. Zuto lokoto, oh rakate te, no more delay. That proverb is gone forever. Italikato, zeto to, zikatata, eso toto, o te, o rakasata, o rakata. toto isato toto to rika jetete rupa kata le toto to mekro dobo shate kiado zeto toto to oh ba pa pasa oh pakasapa. For I am the Lord, I will speak, and the word that I shall speak shall come to pass. It shall be no more prolonged. Ah, posato to 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 to. It shall be no longer prolonged. Roto shekata, zuto to shekato de kudo brada de dodo to. Brika so to 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 to. Zeketa to to reko sopo. Exodus. In ta Ezekiel chapter 12, Itali Crado, Zeto Toto, Zeto Toto, Ricasita da, oh, popo, 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 oh, de, Ezekiel 12:24, there shall be no more any vain vision or no flattering divination. 25, I am the Lord, I will speak, and the word that I shall speak shall come to pass. It shall be no more prolonged. I want you to pray again. It is enough. No more delay. No more prolonged. It cannot be prolonged anymore. It will not be prolonged anymore. Itali grado zato to shata pray rato shoto to ricasto vreda ekuda leshida ye debroto shoto. No more delay. No more delay. No more delay. No more delay. Delay manifestation is now. I want you to speak it. Bible says faith is now. Manifestation is now. No more delay. Thank God. Thank Him for the manifestation of your marriage is now because of the finished work at Calvary, because the Holy Spirit has intervened these last 6 days. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Rako soto toto, reko shato, reko soto toto, momomo soto toto toto, reko shita legre dobo zata, izuturia gadaria gutoria gadababa, reko soto toto, reko soto. No more postponements, no more delay. Hallelujah. Reko shata ye gadabari gado. In Toria Gada. Now we are going to begin to pray into the marriage. Like I said, the wedding is one day. You don't get carried away by all the white dress. We want to pray into the marriage. The Bible says in Mark chapter 3, verse 25, let to, if a house be divided against itself, it cannot stand. I want you to pray. I want you to take a stand against the spirit of division that is ravaging marriages across the globe. That, Lord, I will marry, and my marriage, there will be no division. There will be no divorce. They will not divide our relationship. Right now, from the onset, even before I marry, I speak against division. My marriage will not be divided. My husband and I will not be divided. Ilakuda brotoshe, reko soto, pray, 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 pray. Reko sata, leto toto, mato toshe te di kalibrado zoto yede. Likrado shoto, you wicked spirits that is responsible for division, that is responsible for division in marriages. Bible says a house divided against itself shall not stand. Our house will not be divided. My home will not be divided. We will stand and we will stand as one. We will pray as one. We will serve God as one. We will love you as one. My home will not be divided. Our relationship will not be divided. Itali grado, pray, pray. Reko soto, reto toto, reko shoto. To mato toto makataya lesto toto rita toto rakashiata etoto, you spirits that divide homes, lukrataya, I give you no place. Even tonight, as I pray in agreement with how many over 60 people on this line, I pray that tonight I stake my claim that my marriage will be days of heaven on earth. Days of heaven on earth. I want you to pray that prayer. Days of heaven on earth. I pray, Lord, according to Deuteronomy 11:21, that my days will be multiplied, and the days of my children, and my and the land which the Lord swore unto my fathers to give me, as the days of heaven on earth. Deuteronomy 11:21, days of heaven on earth. My marriage, speak it out. Open your mouth. I've waited this long, so I cannot afford any other thing. My marriage must be days of heaven on earth. It must be days of heaven on the earth. Elikra do soto re bariga soto riaga shiada lesh do 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 ma do de 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 de. Pray as if you mean it. Interligado. Unmute yourself and pray. Amos 3:3. Can two walk together except they be agreed? No, I want you to pray again. Lord, my husband and I will be in agreement. There is a difference between differences here and here than constant discord. That both of us will be in agreement. That will Holy Spirit, you will teach us to walk in agreement. That our house will not be a squabbling house, always arguing, always no. Our house will stand as one. According to Amos 3:3, we will not be divided. We will be agreed. We will walk together. I want you to pray. Give us the grace, oh Lord, to live as one flesh. Pray that prayer. Grace, you need grace. Oh, Rakataba, that we may be an example in this generation. Itali gradobo, ratosto brede, roto I want you to pray. Pray for peace in your house. That it will be full of joy. Celebration. That because that's what you said in your word. That the voice of rejoicing will be in the tabernacle of the righteous. Lord, I speak right now that the voice of rejoicing will not cease in my marriage, will not cease in my household. In the name of Jesus. That your house will be a house of peace. According to John 14, verse 27, he says, my peace, my shalom, my wholeness, I give to you, not as the world gives. So we will pray. In my marriage, there is peace. I have a peaceable marriage. They say it, you will have whatsoever you say. I have a peaceable marriage. My house shall be full of peace. There will be all around joy in my home, in my household, in the name of Jesus. Etulakrodaba no soprakataka orapa. I tell you, it's not enough to marry. You must pray. You must pray for peace. Pray against chaos. Pray against strife. Pray against abuse. Every sadness, every depression. You must refuse it from the onset. Let the foundation be laid. I tell you, I've been married for 10 years. I have never had the cause to struggle in this marriage, and I know it's because of some seeds that has gone. You must sow the seed. You must say, God, I pray against every chaos, every strife, every abuse, every sadness, every depression, every apathy in marriage. It is not my lot. I pray. I have waited this long. I must have a peaceful marriage. I must have a peaceful and a glorious marriage. A peaceful and a glorious marriage. Pray that prayer. Unmute yourself and pray. Rekosato riagataye, reto shata, ekula de bronto sediam broko seto. My mother is a
In the name of Jesus, we shall live in peace.
Good marriages don't just happen by chance. It doesn't just happen because you are beautiful. You need to pray that God, my marriage will be peaceful. My marriage will be peaceful. No abuse, no chaos, no strife. In the name of Jesus, that we will walk as one. Italy do brondo, leke to toto, zipra to soto, ishta de. I want you to pray intentionally. Reko soto yeka. You will not, the marriage you are going to is not a marriage that we're going for 1 year, 2 years, and then no divorce can happen. Say no, God. Makutaye kalebra zuto lebro toshe. Pray. Rikasto bre reto shade. In this marriage that I am going into, it is a marriage for life. It is a peaceful marriage. It is a joyful marriage. According to your word, you said days of heaven and earth. Days of heaven and earth. I receive that according to Deuteronomy 11:21, that I have days. Days of heaven on earth, our days will be multiplied. We will not die younger. We will not die. Have you not heard of people that died 1 year into the marriage? That's not your own. You will not die. Your husband will not die. Ikaria boshata. Your wife will not die. Ita brokoto. Jetoria kata. Ikara dabo akude brotaya. I want you to pray. Likrado soto rekoko soto mato to rekasata zito loko zepro toto. Days of heaven on earth. It is possible to have days of heaven on earth, a marriage that you want to go home every day, a husband that you want to see every day, a wife that you want to see every day. Atola bakata nekro do 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 ropo koko ko shata reto shate koto sheto prekoso to pray ratusha rekoso retosha retosho. There must be peace. This person I'm going to marry, because I know you've given me this person already. There is peace in that home. Marriages are made in heaven, but they have to be lived on earth. That's why you have to pray. Even if God hands you the spouse, you must pray for peace. It doesn't just happen. It's not automatic. You pray that in my household there is rest, in my household there is peace, in my household there is shalom. Rato shato brakataya. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I want you to pray. Again, we are moving on. I want you to pray for wisdom to be married and to stay married. You need wisdom to be married and to stay married. I want you to pray, ask him for wisdom. He said to ask. James says to ask. If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask God. He gives generously to all without reproach. So you need to ask. Say, God, I receive the wisdom. Wisdom to be married and to stay married. I want you to pray, especially if you're a woman on this line. Men, you need the wisdom as well to love your wife. But a woman, I want you to pray, because the Bible says in Proverbs 14, every wise woman builds a house. So you need wisdom. You need wisdom to build a house, to build a home. But the foolish woman plucks it down. That woman is not on this line. We are all wiser. We are all smarter. Wisdom. Ask, he says. Ask. Say, Lord, I ask for wisdom. Wisdom to marry. Wisdom to marry and to stay married. Ilatoriakata, wisdom. When I see my provision, I won't run my mouth. I won't say what I shouldn't say. Father, give me wisdom. Wisdom to know how to position myself, how to speak, how to say the right things. Ilakushta de zoto. Embrato ze proto toto vita de rocochete ricasoto le toto ricachete rato shoto breco su toto soto. Hallelujah. Iprata bakata. Ask for wisdom. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Pray. Hallelujah. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you for your wisdom. We thank you for your wisdom. We ask for wisdom according to James chapter 1, verse 5 to 6. Thank you for your wisdom, your great wisdom over our lives. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We move into Ephesians, the book of Ephesians. We hear what Paul wrote there to husbands and to wife. He says, wives, understand. This is the Message translation. I like this translation. Wives, understand and support your husband in ways that show you support Christ. So if you say you are a Christian, you must understand. You must support your husband. Husband, provide leadership to your wife the way Christ does to his church, the way Christ does to his church, not by domineering, but by cherishing. So just as church submits to Christ, as he exercises such leadership, wives should likewise submit to their own husbands. So I want you to pray as a woman that, Lord Jesus, help me to understand. Help me to support my husband. Holy Spirit, as I go into this journey, help me to understand. Help me to support my husband. Help him to show him support the way I will support you, Jesus Christ. Help me to support to him as he exercises his leadership the way you do to the church. You, man of God, on this line, you will pray, dear Lord, give me the grace to provide leadership to my wife, just like you lead the church. Help me not to be domineering. Instead, Lord, teach me how to cherish my wife. Pray, 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 pray. Very, very important. Lord, help me to understand and to support and to submit to my husband and to show him support, just like I showed Jesus Christ. Utaria kasolodo reko sotoria pakata reto sheto reto soto reku rakatu reko soto ba 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 o rakasakata o rapashoto anto Father. Father, I pray you help me. Oh, help me to love and to support my husband. If you are a man of God, you are praying that God will help you to provide the leadership. Itaria kata, that he will give you the grace to provide leadership, that you will not be a domineering husband, that you not be an abusive husband, that you be a caring husband, a husband that cherishes his wife, just like the scripture says. Eteria katole brado to sata esto preto to in taria kaso to reko shoto to o te. I want you to pray. If you are a woman on this line, I want you to pray that, God, you will make me a virtuous and excellent wife. You will make me a virtuous and excellent wife. Proverbs 12:4. You will make me a virtuous and an excellent wife. Oh, because that is the crown of our husband. And I will not bring my husband shame with my foolishness. In the name of Jesus, I didn't write it. That's what's in the Bible. It says, but she who shames him with her foolishness is like rottenness in his bone. Lord, I pray that you will make me a virtuous and excellent wife. Oh, so that my husband can be proud of me. Husband, you will pray. Man of God on the line, you, the men on the line, you will pray that Lord will give you a wife that is that grace, that has her, that a hearty wife, an excellent and virtuous wife, that you will always be proud of her. That God will give her grace to please you. Grace to please you. I want you to pray that. All the men on the line, I want you to pray with gusto, dear Lord, that you will give me a wife. Oh, rakasatata, give my wife the grace to be a hearty wife, that you will make me proud, just like the scripture says, that you will give you a virtuous and an excellent wife, worthy of honor. Pray that prayer. Rekusatulia gata tata tata ta roto toto toto to rato toto to rato shete broto soto ente kra. We only have a few more prayer points. I want you to pray, Lord, according to 1 Peter 3:7, that likewise, husband, I'm speaking to husbands, that they will dwell with us, will dwell with your wife, oh, according to knowledge. Oh, kariaka sole brata shata, reto toto, oh, prakasata tasoto pakasha, gisa pukata. Oh, woman of God, pray that God will give your husband the grace to be good to you, to help him to honor and to delight in you. Men of God, you pray that, Lord, you help me to be a good husband to my wife. You will teach me to honor and to delight in her and to treat her as my equal, and I'm reading from the scriptures directly, that your prayers be not hindered. 1 Peter 3:7, I want you to pray, 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 pray. Rato shato brakasuta zekoto no grondo rato shoto latetete roko shoto rato toto jatoto shata reko soto reto toto monto krakazaka reto toto otatata reto toto otatata osototo mosoko Tiata, Zuto Korea Katala, Roto Toto, O Rakaso, O Soto Toto, O Rakakasoto, Reto Toto, O Rakasuto Toshoto, Mosoto Toto, O Rapapa, O Ropo Shoto Toto Kosata. Press some more, press some more, press some more. Lord, I pray, help me to understand, help me to support my wife. Woman of God, pray, O Tata. Tata, Lord, help me to support my husband. Isanita to Soto. I tell you, Ratoshato, Retete, Rikashuta, Lanto, Breto Shata, Reto Toto Toto, Uratatatatatatatototo, Urakashuto, Reto Shote, Rikashoto, Aleto Brata, Reto Soto. Praise God. I want you to unmute yourself and begin to thank Him, begin to praise Him for this time. There's quite a few prayer points, but unfortunately, not to leave. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. If I were you, I don't know where you're at, calling from wherever you are in the world, I will spend the next 1 hour just praising Him. Just praising Him. I tell you, one of the things I did, and I still do till today, is I consciously thank Him. You know, I thank Him. I used to call it jamming for the lamb. I want you, I just spend sometimes 30 minutes, 1 hour, just dancing and praising God. Because you, there are some things you can't do by yourself, but He can do it. Hallelujah. I want you to thank you for this 7 days that you've joined us. It's been a great honor and privilege just being able to stand before you and I need to see my screen. Yes. To stand before you and pray with you. Like I said, somebody said, when do I stop praying? When you walk down the aisle. you need to go back and pray and praise and praise and pray and get no room for depression, no room for anything else. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Before I go tonight, I wanted, like I said yesterday, our next upcoming meeting is on December the 5th, and it's 1:30 p.m. UK time, and for all the folks calling from Africa, it's 2:30 in Nigeria. If you want to be included in that meeting, especially if you are from Nigeria, just send your email address in. We'll be sending out the invites this week. And December 19, you don't want to miss it, is our evening of testimonies and sax praise. You are going to hear some testimonies that night. I tell you, you will dance. God is no respecter of persons. If He's done it for these ladies, He's going to, and these gents, because we have gents coming to testify, He is going to do it for you. You are next in line. There shall be a performance of the things God has spoken. I thank you. Thank you for joining. God bless you. I want to acknowledge Minister Marlene McKenzie from Canada. I see your hand up. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you for joining us. You are a super, super blessing. It's a privilege to serve God with you. God bless you, everyone, and have a great night. And I don't hesitate to send us your testimonies. You are next in line. Say amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Amen.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Thank you so much.
Amen. Thank you.
May he make his face shine upon you and may he be gracious to you and your family. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Dupsi, for all the prayers.
Behind the scene contribution, your testimony. And everything. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. God bless you. Bye.
Bless you, ma'am.